Hello and welcome to this video on setting up a scan target. What we've completed so far, or to help with your installation, your configuration process, you should have completed the installation process, which is going to include creating a Lansweeper site, installing it on the server, as well as creating a scanning credential. Again, by default, Lansweeper will scan that subnet or the VLAN that it's sitting on, which we'll show you in a few minutes. But I want to emphasize here that the order is not critical between the scanning credentials or the scanning targets. You can do them in any order you want. I just find creating a scanning credential which needs to be assigned to a scanning target is the best order to do with this in. So with that, let's jump into Lansweeper and create a scanning target. All right, once you've logged into Lansweeper, we're going to come over to the scanning section. And let's select scanning targets and all targets. You can see here by default, upon installation, Lansweeper has discovered my domain, my user path. It has also discovered the domain name as well as the computer name here on top. And it's got the IP ranged from the subnet mask that has been discovered on the scanning server. But I want to add a different IP range to my scanning targets. So I'm going to come over to the scanning target. And you can see here the different type of scan targets we can create. Again, another computer path if we want an Active Directory, again, the domain or a user path. We can also go into Intune, a specific Windows machine that maybe you want to target. But what I'm going to do for this installation is a specific IP range. Let me pause right here and just emphasize that if you have more than one scan server in your environment, you can actually use this feature inside of the scanning target to select the specific scan server that you want to use that particular target. This also means that you can have one target IP range be assigned to two different scan servers. And that way, maybe one scans in the morning, one scans at night. It's up to you how you want to configure your installation. So with my target here, I'm going to select my single and only scan server and select add target. From here, there's a lot of information on this page. So let's go through slowly and discover what each of these buttons and fields do. To start with, I'm going to enter my IP range of 10.40.0.1 through 10.40.0.30. You can actually put a description if you want for my fabrication lab. And we can actually schedule how frequently you want this environment to be scanned. Of course, you can do every day. You can choose the separation between minutes or hours. You can choose every day on a specific time. If there's certain days of the week of different times, you can also select those differently and choose based off of what you want on the time that you want. And if you want to have no scanning, which is kind of funny to think about, but it's very possible that you have this set up to have no scanning schedule configured for this because you want to manually trigger this installation in this particular scan. So none is also available. If you want to disable this and maybe have this for future reference, you can even disable this scan target. Let's talk about these fields over here about pinging and saving an IP. In this particular field, a ping and save IP means that it's going to ping out across the network and save any information and asset that it has discovered on your network. If I have selected ping, this is purely and only pinging the assets that have been discovered on the network, and it will not create a new asset. And of course, you can select don't ping. The use case for this one is, if you're scanning that environment, it's only going to scan the assets that have been discovered in that environment and not re-ping and find new ones. For this, I want to install ping and save IP. Now, again, we can decide how we want to scan this in our new scan server target. We can scan all, we can scan all except Windows, and we can scan new Windows devices only. Again, I want to, in my lab here, I want to discover everything inside of my IP range. I'm going to select all. The ping timeout can be configured by the seconds. If you have a phone system and have SIP ports, you can modify this default setting. And if you have a unique SSH port, you can configure that here as well, or disable it completely. Next, this is where we can actually configure those newly created scan credentials that we created earlier. Scroll down and you can choose any of the scanning credentials you want. You can select only the one you want. Maybe you want to select all. It's up to you. Lansweeper allows you to choose how you want this to be created. Once this is done, it's really easy. Hit save, exit, and now it's going to ask you, do you want to scan right now with the scan target you've created? In my situation, I do, because I know I don't have any assets in my Lansweeper installation yet. I'm going to click next. And there it is. It's been created. You can see it in the list. Since it's here in this list and it's currently doing its scanning, let's talk about what we see here. This is another location here. Maybe I've installed my Lansweeper in this environment, but I don't want it to scan this environment. I can turn this particular scan off. Maybe I want to actually trigger in the middle of the day a different type of outside of my scan schedule. I can actually scan a specific path or a specific scan target at any time by simply collecting scan now, and you can see it's been added to my scanning queue. And I think with that, that concludes this video on setting up a scan target. As you can see, we have created a scan target that points specifically at a specific network. You can add many more networks in here or specific individual machines. But until the next video, happy sweeping and discover what's on your network.